Gwadar, the gateway to prosperity. For more than 2,000 years, Central Asia has been a meeting ground for Europe and Asia. Ancient Islamic cities like Tashkent, Samarkand, and Bukhara were once considered major trading centers in the region. Central Asia was a birthplace of civilization and political powers. The Silk Route was an important trading route linking China with Central Asia, Europe, and the Middle East. Obor is the modern version of Silk Route. Obor, One Belt, One Road, initiative would link two-thirds of world population and two-thirds of known energy resources. CPEC, China-Pakistan Economic Corridor, is a part and parcel of Obor initiative. This route was regarded as the most vital trade link, fulfilling the trade requirement of the civilization flourishing along it. Along this ancient trade route, the Khyber Pass between region of Pakistan and Afghanistan is one of the best known natural mountain paths in the world. The Khyber Pass not only provided entry point for conquerors like Alexander the Great, Persians, Mongols, and Mughal armies, it has also served as strategic important trade route for centuries. In the modern geopolitical scenario, Central Asia continues to have special significance with reference to its geography and potential for development of trade links with the rest of the world. Central Asian states, although rich in natural resources, are landlocked. The Central Asian states and Transcaucasus Republic of Azerbaijan possess large resources of oil and gas that can to a large extent fulfill the global needs. However, the only viable route for this region is the warm water of Indian Ocean. The most feasible route to reach the Indian Ocean is the Pakistani deep sea port at Gwadar. Gwadar is located along the busiest sea lane which links Persian Gulf with the rest of the world. CPEC, i.e. road and rail link between Gwadar and China, will transform the geoeconomics of economical depression Western China. It will help Western China to circumvent the long land and sea route, reducing transportation time from 45 days to 10 days. And save up to $200 billion in transportation and logistics cost. The emergence of Central Asian states has added to its value. Considering the geoeconomic significance of Central Asian transit trade, the Asia Development Bank study identified Gwadar Deep Seaport as the most vital transit point for Central Asian Republic. Gwadar's extensive foreland has important economic consequences for Middle East, Europe, and Africa. Neighbor countries like Iran has a very long coastline, Iraq at the head of the Persian Gulf, Bahrain, Kuwait, Saudi Arabia, Qatar, UAE, and Oman. The port of Dubai is located along the Persian Gulf and together with Omani port of Salalah served as a vital transshipment and trading centers. More than 85% of its shipping cargo is re-exported, transforming these ports into trading centers. Gwadar's strategic location will transform it into trading center. It is expected that transshipment from Dubai and other Gulf ports will eventually relocate it to Gwadar deep seaport. Although Gwadar's primary business expected to be from the hinterland countries like China and Central Asian Republic, but oil and gas business from foreland countries will transform Gwadar deep seaport into transit and transshipment center. The government of Pakistan planned development of Gwadar in 1960s and started development on 23rd March 2002. The key factors in government decision of development Gwadar are capitalize opportunities of trade with Central Asian Republics and China, promote trade and transshipment with the Gulf, transit and transshipment essentially for containerized cargo to unlock the economic potential of the hinterland, socioeconomic uplift of Baluchistan, to facilitate the development of petrochemical industries, industrial parks. Gradually, Gwadar will be transformed into commercial and trading hub of the region as a first world planned seaport of this century. Three main areas of development has been identified: the deep seaport, The Free Zone, with ultra-modern facilities of manufacturing, transit, and transshipment facilities to transform the Gwadar into the first smart city in Pakistan. Residential and commercial areas will be separated by highway converge on port. On completion of the project, Gwadar will be the most strategic located port of the world. The development of Gwadar Deep Seaport is undertaken by Chinese Overseas Port Holding Company. Gwadar Deep Seaport will be the third biggest deep seaport of the world, catering the needs of ultra-modern post-Panamax ships. By virtue of its absolute and relative location, Gwadar Deep Seaport will become the hub of maritime transportation. The Pakistan and Chinese government are planning early development dedicated to the additional berths. Gwadar Eastern Zone has been dedicated for Gwadar New Age Industrial Free Zone, providing ultra-modern facilities to manufacturing sector, including high-tech manufacturing. Approximately 15,000 hectares reserves for this purpose. 4,000 hectares is allocated for the special industrial zones, with an addition of 6,000 hectares for future expansion. 100 hectares is allocated for oil refinery, so Gwadar shall be developed as a petrochemical industrial hub, similar to Jubail and Singapore. Government is also planning to give incentives to heavy industries like copper, iron, and steel. 100 hectares is reserved for export processing zone offers liberal economic and legal incentives like 100% ownership, duty-free import, no excise and custom duty on construction material, and cheap labor make viable program for growth. The Gwadar residential and commercial area is planned on 1,000 hectares. The residential and commercial belt shall be separated by highway converge on port. Special area is allocated for tourism-related activities along the West Bay. Gwadar will become the hub of foreign direct investment, especially of Chinese origin. Hub status will transform the real estate values in Gwadar. In real estate sector, return on investment shall be highest in Pakistan. SNS Real Estate is the only entity which provides comprehensive and objective assessment of real estate opportunities in Gwadar. For more information, contact us on